मॉर्निंग टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डेमोन्स्ट्रेट अब्डोमिनल एग्जामिनेशन लियोपोल्ड मैन्युवर फॉर द सेक ऑफ एजुकेशन पर्पस फॉर अंडर ग्रेजुएट नर्सिंग स्टूडेंट्स वी हैव ए पेशेंट टुडे बुतैना आली अहमद एंड शी इज ग्रेविड ऑफ 4 एंड शी इज ड्यू फॉर टुडेज एंटीनेटल क्लिनिक शी केम हियर एंड आई विल डेमोन्स्ट्रेट यू हाउ टू डू द लियोपोल्ड मैन्युवर Okay, let us go and see the mother. Hello, Butaina, how are you?
Fine.
Okay, you came for routine clinic. How do you feel today?
No, today morning my baby not moving well.
Oh, no problem. We will check your baby, how he is and his heart rate and everything. And I hope you go to bathroom and give urine to the nurse to check.
Yes, yes.
Your urine... Still showing the glucose plus 3. You did not have your medication. You were ordered with metformin 500 gram.
I forgot to take that metformin.
Oh. But otherwise you were okay. Everything was okay. So far you are now 36 weeks. Anyway, Butaina, we will check you and we will let you know how is your baby and everything. Okay?
Okay.
Good. Is it okay? You are here. Your temperature is fine. I will provide you privacy. I will
fine, sister. Fine.
Curtain. I will provide you.
Fine.
So, by the way, your full name is Butaina Ali Ahmad.
Yeah.
So, is it okay? You feel comfortable with me? I will just examine your abdomen to see your baby is fine. Okay.
See my baby.
I will just wash my hands and then I'll come back to you. Okay. For abdominal examination, I have arranged measuring tape to take the fundal height and some tissue to wipe off the gel. And I have a sonic aid which is working. And this is for fetal heart rate monitoring. And there is a gel here. And these are the equipments which I have already prepared for you to examine. Okay, fine. So, is this position okay with you, Butaina?
Yes, yes.
So we usually place the mother in supine position with one pillow. And when I do the examination, you can flex your knee just to make you relaxed and all. Okay?
Okay.
Let me just take out this. And sometimes if you feel dizzy or if you feel some discomfort, just tell me. That's so I will just make you comfortable only. And when I touch, if you feel some pain, also you tell me. Okay?
Okay.
I just want to move you little bit towards me so that I can examine you very well. Okay, Butaina? Is it fine?
Okay.
So always make the mother towards you so that you will not stretch out too much and you will have more handy things. Usually we examine mother general appearance. She looks happy, pleasant, and her hydration status is fine. She does not look pale and all. All for other three babies you breastfed very well, you know.
Yes, yes.
So you don't have any breastfeeding problem. Babies are fine.
Yeah.
Are they doing good at home?
Yes, they are.
Okay.
Fine.
Maybe they are excited with waiting for the baby and all.
Yeah, they are waiting for that.
So she just have regular skin changes on the face and neck and all, and her breast also looks. She reported that she has breastfeeding, so no problem identified or reported so far. Now we will do the abdominal examination. Okay, and you are okay, no?
Yeah.
Yeah. So sometimes we can place some roll of towel on the right side so that the mother cannot go into supine hypotension and only expose the area which you needed. You don't feel cold, you know? I will just quickly do it. Okay, Leopold manual has got, first is inspection. So you need to inspect the mother abdominal shape. Her abdominal shape looks like oval. Oval is a normal common shape, which means that the baby is in almost longitudinal lie, and she is gravida 4, but her abdomen is good shape and in oval shape, and the size also looks to me almost like appropriate for her gestational weeks. As per her LMB, she is in 36 weeks. Okay, and I Bhutaina, you are so lucky, you don't have any skin stretch mark. Usually the mother have the stretch marks like a pink stretch mark, that is called striae gravidarum. And some pregnant women who is already gravida 3, gravida 2, they have silvery stretch mark, which is the old mark for the previous pregnancy, which represent previous pregnancy. And also you have to look for linea nigra, which is the brownish dark line extending from symphoid process to the symphysis pubis. And so you are so lucky, you don't have any changes. All your previous deliveries, pregnancy, labor was all normal. So there is no mark of cesarean section or no previous scars or anything. Her umbilicus looks little protruded, which is normal for 36 weeks. Okay. And I could not see any visible fetal movement on you. Anyway, we will check your fetal heart rate and your baby and all. Okay, fine. The size, shape, fetal movement, skin changes, and fetal part is fine. So the contour also looks firm to me. You are maintaining yourself, exercising and everything. The contour is not pondulous or laxed. It's firm contour. So that's coming to the end of the abdominal examination inspection part. Next, we will go to the fundal height assessment. Okay. The fundal height assessment simply means we are just measuring the vertical length of the uterus from symphysis pubis to the upper margin of the fundus. So first you identify the landmarks. So look, feel the symphysis pubis with two finger and feel the xiphoid process with two finger. And when you are with your ulnar border, you try to palpate, taking hand up and down, and feel the upper margin of the fundus. Okay, this is the margin, landmarks for your fundal height. Then you can measure this distance from symphysis pubis to the upper margin of the fundus. See, this is okay, I can feel it now. This is 36 centimeter. Okay, it should be in line with umbilicus. So now I can feel that's 36 centimeter. Normally in the appropriate gestational age, it corresponds to the weeks of gestation up to 36 weeks. It can be plus or minus 2. And if you need to critically think, this fundal height is one of the landmark findings where you can relate with whether there is a polyhydramnios, multiple pregnancy, intrauterine growth retardation. If it is expected height is very low, meaning low intrauterine growth retardation, baby is not growing properly. And in other ways around, if it is higher than what is expected, it may be polyhydramnios or macrosomic baby or multiple pregnancy. So the fundal height part is over. Next is our Leopold number. Okay, palpation part. Okay, for palpation we are using the finger pads. Okay, both hands finger pads. Make sure you warm your hands very well, and not sometimes the mother gets cold hand, jerky, and the patient does not feel so many. And turn yourself to the face of the mother. Okay, mama, I'm going to just feel what. First part is the fundal palpation. You can feel with the upper pole of the fundus and see how you feel the upper pole. What part of the fetus is occupying in the upper poles? This is the way. So you keep the hands together and try to feel gently with your finger pads. So this is the movement and this is the position. So I can feel a soft, round, irregular mass. It's not mobile also. So When you feel the fundus with the fetal part, you finished the first part of the Leopold maneuver. So the next is lateral palpation. Move your hands towards the lateral sides. Okay, then you stabilize the nearest hand. This is mother's right hand, and then this is the left hand of the left side of the mother. So using your right hand, because it's the left side of the mother, you try to palpate from top to bottom and feel how you feel the fetal part in that part, the lateral part. See, I felt a continuous mass. Okay, if you don't feel at a stretch, what you can do, you can go little bit up like this, or you can go down until you feel what is the presenting part there. Okay, then you stabilize that hand. You try to use the same technique here in the nearest part and try to palpate the right side or the nearest place. See, here I can feel some indentations and some nodular appearance. It can be the limb part. So what is the purpose of the lateral palpation is to determine the fetal back. So here I could feel more smooth continuous mass of the fetus here. So this is the lateral palpation, second part of the Leopold. Then the third part of the Leopold, step one, is the pelvic grip. Okay, mama, you just raise your, flex the knee so that it will not be more painful for you. You will feel little discomfort. Is it okay? Just take a deep breath. Okay, fine. Okay, now you take your index finger and thumb. Try to catch hold, grip the pelvic area. Try to find and try to approach both finger together and feel what is occupying in the lower poles like this. And now I could feel a hard round mass which is more mobile also. This will determine what is the presenting part in the lower pole of the uterus and also the attitudes. Then the third part, the second part of the third Leopold maneuver is the pelvic, the movements. You have to use your both hands and try to approach the uterus together in a downward and inward movements. See, this way. See, here now I can approach both hands together, meaning the presenting part is not descended down, it is still up, and the attitude also we can determine this way. So this is the last part of the Leopold maneuver. Now palpation part is finished. Are you okay, mama? You can be resting. Okay, now the next step is auscultation part. What we are really auscultating here, we need to identify where is the maximum point of intensity or point of maximum intensity where you can feel here the fetal heart rate very well. Okay, for this we use this sonic aid. Okay, it will give you the rate and it will give you the sound also, and it has got a ultrasonography diaphragm. Then you apply the gel. Okay, mama, I will just apply the gel and then you will feel little cold. Is it okay for you? Okay, okay. Now where I will apply, you divide the abdomen into four. Okay, so these are the upper right and left quadrant, this is the lower right and left quadrant. Now I feel the back in this side, and I feel the head is more down here. So normally where we get the fetal heart rate, any heart rate, heart is in the left side, and so it will be more reflective and more heard through the left shoulder. So if the head is here, if the back is here, it will be in the left lower quadrant. So I am placing it here. Okay, mama, is it fine?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, can you hear, mama, the sound?
Yeah.
Okay, so you will, okay, I will also see. Now it is 146 per minute. So your baby is doing fine. You can hear the sound. Okay, mama?
Okay, okay.
Okay, Mama?
Okay.
See.
Yeah.
You are happy?
Yeah, now I am happy.
Okay.
Okay, I'm relaxed now.
Okay, so your baby is doing fine. So far, everything is good. We will ask your doctor to see also. So after you note the rate and the rhythm also regular now, okay?
Okay.
You can, your baby is doing so far good, Mama. Okay, fine. Then remove the gel. Okay. Okay, Mama. Is it everything okay with you?
Yeah.
Do you feel okay?
Okay.
Okay, fine, Mama. Thank you. I will now record all your findings in your green card and you can wait in the corridor where doctor will call you. Okay?
Okay.
Take care.
Thank you.
And now the recording part is important. You really need to identify, record the findings, especially the lie. Lie means the relationship of the fetal spine to the maternal spine. If this is the baby spine and this is the mother spine, so how it is related? If it is same level, it is longitudinal. If it is in the opposite side, it is transverse. Then it is in the oblique side, like this. Okay. So this mother, I could feel the back all the way straight. So it is. Lie is longitudinal, and I can feel the gestational age is appropriate because it was 36 centimeter frontal height and the 36 shape also looks like almost like. Now I could feel the head down, so this is a vertex presentation. So I this was the feeling I got it. So it was mobile also, it was not descended down, and the head was like this. So it was a vertex presentation. Okay. Depending on whichever part comes down, or if the vertex is coming, it is breech presentation. If it is shoulder presentation, then this is whichever part you feel down, you will label it as presentation. Then now the position is the another one you will identify. If it is a vertex presentation, especially fully flexed attitude, it has got 6 different positions. It can directly come into the anterior position. This is anterior vertex, occiputo anterior position. If it comes and touches in the posterior part, it is occiputo posterior position. If the occiput comes into the, this is the right left side of the mother, so this is left occiputo anterior, left occiputo lateral, left occiputo posterior. In the same pattern, right occiputo anterior, right occiputo lateral, right occiputo posterior. So these are the main things. So we have to record the fundal height, gestational age calculation, and you make a comment like that. Then lie, attitude, presentation, position, fetal heart rate is very important. Write the rate, rhythm also. Thank you.